In the previous video, I introduced the statement of the second part of the fundamental theorem of calculus, and I gave an example of how to use it. In this video, I will write down a proof for this theorem. As a reminder, here's what the theorem says. I begin with a function, little f, that must be continuous on an interval ab, and I want to compute its definite integral. The theorem says that if I take any antiderivative g of f, then the definite integral of f from a to b is the antiderivative at b minus the antiderivative at a. That's what we want to prove. Here's how the proof goes. The only thing I know about g is that this is an antiderivative of f, or in other words, the derivative of g is little f. So that's what I'm going to use about g. I can't use anything else. And as a reminder, what I want to show is that the integral from a to b of f of x dx is g of b minus g of a. In this proof, I am going to use the first part of the fundamental theorem of calculus because we have already proven that one separately. So imitating that part, I'm going to introduce a new function. I'm going to define the function big F as an integral of little f. So big f of x is equal to the integral from a to x of f of t dt. So this is a function that wasn't part of the statement of the theorem. I'm introducing it as part of the proof. And in terms of this function, what I am trying to prove can be rewritten this way. I want to show that big f of b is equal to g of b minus g of a. So I'm trying to show that there is this relation between big f and big g. What we know about big f comes from the first part of the fundamental theorem of calculus. Since big F is defined as an integral of little f, it must be an antiderivative. Or specifically, since little f is continuous, by the fundamental theorem of calculus part 1, the derivative of big F must be equal to little f. And so at this moment, I have two different antiderivatives of little f. One that I constructed, the other one that was part of the statement. And therefore, I have two functions with the same derivative. And we know that when we have two functions with the same derivative, f and g, they must differ by a constant. So f minus g is constant. This is due to a consequence of the mean value theorem. In other words, there exists a real constant c such that big f of x equals g of x plus c. This must be true for all values of x on the domain, on the interval. So this gives me partially the relation between big F and g. Now I want to figure out what this constant is. And to do that, I'm going to evaluate both sides of the equation at the same point. And I'm going to choose to evaluate at a to figure out the value of the constant, because at a, one of them is easy to compute. Specifically, big F of a is 0. That is by its definition. Big F of a will be the integral from a to a of something, so that is 0. So 0 must be equal to g of a plus c, plus the constant. And from here, I can solve and conclude that the constant must be equal to minus g of a. So to summarize, what I have concluded is that for every real number x on the interval from a to b, big f of x is equal to g of x minus g of a. That's the value of the constant. In particular, when I take x to be equal to b, this means that big F of b is equal to g of b minus g of a. But look at the top, that is exactly what we needed to prove. That's what we wanted. And therefore, this concludes the proof.